You're always a victim of culture. So, I'm going to talk to you a little bit about communication in the future. In the future, people say, is that good material to use in the structure? They say yes. The next thing is, what's its tensile strength, torsional strength, compression strength? What is it? We don't know yet. Let me know when you find out. Then I will make a decision that's appropriate to the use of that material. Do you understand what that means? If you make a fishing net that tears a lot, another person comes up with material, but you have to spend 4 years making it, says, I'll make what I've already got. The advantage of a system has to be within a reasonable amount of time. Therefore, if people are not reasonable, reasonable people will say, let's live together to see if our values coincide. And if they don't, they separate, but they're not mad at each other because their values don't coincide. If you meet a girl that you wish to get along with, you express your values. She says, they're completely unacceptable to me. That means you won't be able to get along. If she says yes, I'd like to learn more about it, I accept some of them. Then there's a basis. But if she gets mad at you, she may reject the values. So her methods, in other words, if you're a very good engineer, but you're a mean person, I should listen to your engineering, not your meanness. You have to learn what the advantage is of the system you're in, and learn not to reject the person, but to reject certain aspects of the values you can't use. If a guy is very good at growing food, but he's a Seventh-day Adventist, you don't need those values, you need the growing food values. So they are extensional to you in certain areas. That's why, again, anyone that sets out to communicate would have to know roughly where they want to go. Now, you can only communicate in a limited way when you talk of structures. But when you talk of chemistry, you can communicate in a certain range. But when it comes to human behavior and values, the girl says, Sam is not good looking enough for me. That has to do with personal values. Has nothing to do with communication. I would marry a crab if the crab was extensional. Do you understand what I mean? But the crab would have to be extensional in many areas. Okay? And if the crab says, you will learn to love me over a period of 4 years due to your old conditioning, I may not be able to accept that. That's why communication is so difficult. It's what you're able to accept also. All your stuff is very logical, but it does not please me. There are people that will say that. Your thinking is perfectly logical, but I don't feel good about it. So I'm going back to my old feel-good system. Do you understand? Communication has to be something like, what have we here? I don't know. And when you study it, are you studying trees in relation to the symbiotic process? Are you studying trees in relation to edible fruits? What is the kind of study you're doing? So communication requires locking your frame of reference to what it is you're studying that and why you're studying it. Do you have any questions in that area? Therefore, if you ask me again, what's a good way of communicating, I cannot answer that. Or is communication possible? I would say not today. That the communication between Democrats and Republicans are not about physical reference. They're about physical reference related to the Democrats and the Republicans, but not about what you would call relativistic values. relative values, as a man may not give a damn of whether the planet Venus rotates or not. That is of no value to the average person, especially a plumber, unless he's interested in astronomy. So there are many things that are true, but are of no value to another person. If you go in to study the brain and you know all about how it works, I says, persons may not have any use for that, and it will be non-extensional to that person. Do you understand? So, if you ask a normal person, what are you interested in? He says, I'm interested in the science of communication. Can you look at things without bringing your old values into it? He says, I think I can. Test them out. And if he can't, say, I can't communicate with you. Communication is any means whatsoever that can affect another person's behavior. So communication is possible only within limited areas and relative to what they seek. That's the basis of this subject. Now, if I came to another planet, if I wanted to live there, I'd have to ask, is there oxygen, nitrogen, edible food, water? Then I can't live there. Can I bring that stuff there? Then I can live there. Do I have the means of transporting it? Yes. Then I can live there. You know what I mean? You can't communicate with another planet. You have to study the other planet and ask whether it offers survival means for you. Is that clear? I'm talking about communication purely, regardless of culture. And that's very difficult. So I would say that a person in an airplane doesn't really want to aim to shoot down another plane. He likes to press a button and have the enemy plane explode. That's what he really wants. If you teach him how to aim and shoot and maneuver, he really doesn't know. He says, all I want to do is get rid of that guy instantaneously without any threat to me. That would be very... Anybody that can communicate that well would not be a soldier in the first place and will not have many friends. Can you understand that? How to win friends and influence people means to accept established methods of communication. Is that clear? Influencing other people, I love your choice of clothing, and I love the house you designed, and I think your children are simply charming. Then you communicate. If you want to get along with people. Now, if you seek to get along with people, you have no business studying communication, unless you have questions.
When you talked about what you were going to discuss today, you did it in a simple way I thought was interesting, talking about how the Democrats couldn't communicate with the Republicans, like you said, because there's
no basis.
Because there's a vested interest. But in the future, you didn't put it that way, but you're talking about there would be more relevant communication if it's relevant to the real world.
If you tell them what a vested interest is, a lot of people don't even know what that is. They don't even know the motivation for their question. When a person says, I'm interested in communication, they have to be ignorant.
Can you discuss how it would be different within a resource-based economy?
Well, in a resource-based economy, people are brought up to understand how they relate to their immediate environment, and that their relationship to the environment is not the whole truth. It's as far as we know up to now. As long as you're brought up that way, you know that you're not given a real total understanding of anything, because that's not possible. You're brought up to date and you're told that as we seek more and more information, we will know more about a given subject. Right now, a person might in the future say, I'm not prepared to discuss that. I don't know enough about it. That'd be a wonderful thing to live at a time when people begin to talk that way. I don't know enough about it to make a decision. I don't have enough information. What a wonderful world that would be. Do you think you can live with Jennifer? I don't know. I really don't know. You don't know. How do you know? You don't know what damage they have in their own existence, what values they may bring in the future due to their background. But if you know that you only know limited aspects of something, and it's relative to your background, then you have advantages. You may have the only advantage of the 10 people you talk to. You may be the one only to recognize the advantages, not the other people. The other people might condemn you and say that you're not practical. Well, practical means adjusted to that set of values. When you move in with a primitive tribe, don't try to bring your values in there. You bring whatever you can, and if you can't, you withdraw. You don't talk about things they can't grasp at all. Especially if a person believes in such things as fixed notions, that certain people are beautiful. I can assure you, if people had lips that consume food, just a lips mood, that would be normal to your culture and be beautiful to you, but not to an outsider. That's why you can't say, this is it. You can only say, I like this because I am of that. Do you know what I mean by that? Okay.